Check this out. So Ryan Garcia has this to say to Devin Haney, and I'll break it all down. He tells Devin, I need my money back if they overrule my victory. I paid him money, and that was to accept the weight. So give me my effing money back. So Ryan Garcia is talking about this, Devin Haney and his team, and it's not being, I haven't seen so many boxing fans united on one topic like this. Even on own, go on Devin's own pages, his own social media, you'll see fans are grilling him, they're cooking him. Ray Jackson, you could check him out, what he has to say, that this is super weak. This is like someone took your lunch money and you went to the principal. Handle it like a man. But what happens is Ryan Garcia missed weight, but he tried to make weight. He really did. I know that for a fact. Talking to Ryan's team, he just couldn't. 143.2. And Devin had a lot of options. He could have fought Arnold Barbosa, who was there as a replacement, and Arnold Barbosa was there in case one of them doesn't make weight, or in case one of them doesn't make it to fight night. Or Haney could have said, you know, I'm not fighting you. All these antics, you miss weight, I'm out, I'm fighting someone else, not fighting you right now. Instead, Devin took money. He himself tweeted that he took $1.5 million. It's on Twitter. You can see it on Devin's Twitter, Ryan's Twitter, they both confirmed it. And he agreed to fight. You can't complain afterwards that, oh, I lost because he was overweight. Then why'd you fight him then? And regarding the positive test, well, the jury's still out. They said first two substances, then they changed it to one substance. That was wrong to put out there that he failed two different substances. I'm not an expert, I'm not a chemist, I'm not a scientist, I'm not a food engineer, I'm not a physicist. I don't know about steroids, and I think most people don't know. But I do know Ryan doesn't take over-counter medication, and I do not believe that he would purposely cheat. And there's other MMA fighters that have failed the same thing, and they said may have been from smoking weed, may have been from cross-contamination. So that means you take like a protein shake or you take some herbal stuff, and they're testing all of the stuff that Ryan took to see if that was the source. But on May 22nd, we'll get the answer from the B sample. Ryan maintains his innocence, and Devin Haney is fighting for the commission before even getting the B sample to try to have it overturned, get Ryan disqualified, and get the victory. And one of the reasons that they listed Team Ryan Garcia, Pat English is his lawyer, one of the was Ryan Garcia, he says, purposely missed weight and came in overweight. But once you agreed to accept money for it, once you agreed that that's the route you go, you can't complain. Cannot complain about something. It just makes Haney look even worse. I don't know if Devin has a PR person, but he definitely needs one. He's a professional PR firm to handle his image. His image now is very low. He needs to just, you're a boxer, you're a champion, dust it off, you lost the fight, take the L, come back and fight. You're supposed to fight Sandor Martin, that's your mandatory. Sandor Martin, that's a very tough fight for Haney. 50-50, a 55-45 for Sandor. Sandor gave to a female hell of a fight, and he beat Mikey. Doesn't have a lot of power, only has 6 knockouts. But definitely, if Haney takes him on, that would be a very interesting fight for Haney to test himself. And maybe he vacates the belt and goes another round. Maybe he goes back to Mexico for another 15 fights just to rebuild his confidence and his image. But he definitely needs help with PR. You can't run to ESPN the day it was announced without the facts coming out based on one reporter saying, like, oh, Ryan tested positive for two different kinds of steroids just a few days later to find out that it's only been one kind. And then when MMA fighters fail, the same thing, this ostrich thing. Sean O'Malley failed it twice. I think it was cross-contamination and maybe smoking weed. And Ryan does smoke weed and cross-contamination. Ryan takes herbal supplements and maybe other things. It may not be on the label. And we have to wait and see. May 22nd, the B sample's coming back. But you definitely can't say, oh, he missed weight and therefore overturn. You took money and you agreed to it. Everything was missing. Like I said, in boxing, it's amazing. In other countries, Russia, Eastern Europe, Europe, Middle East, you have to be certified to be a coach, any kind of coach. You have to go to school for 2 years, 6 months, 3 years. You want to coach basketball, you have to be certified. You want to coach, you have to have knowledge about a sport. You have to prove that you're knowledgeable. You have to school, you went to school for it. Boxing is the only sport that someone can come off the street and in one day, oh, I'm a cut man. What are your qualifications? We don't know. I'm friends with the fighter. Oh, I'm a coach. What's your qualifications? I don't know. Oh, I'm a PR person. I do PR for I'm a manager. It's wide open spaces, so it gives people opportunities. That's great. But also, it's a disservice for fighters. Like right now, if I'm Devin, you need a crisis management team, like a real, real PR firm, because right now, Devin is taking the worst beating on social media from fans, from Ryan, than he took in on fight night. And I saw another comment from someone who said, hey, Devin's actually fighting through the commission harder than he fought on fight night to beat Ryan. So just stay low, get back in the ring, and show people you're a champion. Show people what you got. Not demanding, oh, I demand you overturn it, disqualify him. We'll keep you guys posted, but that is the latest. Ryan is popular as ever. Every day he posts some other stuff and it goes viral no matter what he's doing. He's feeding pigs and pelicans, and he's just rapping and having fun and saying that he's officially fighting Spence in August. And today he's going to say that he's fighting someone else, and tomorrow he's fighting else, and eventually he will get in the ring, but we don't know who. So that is the latest. So there you have it. Stay tuned for YouTubeReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. And one more thing, I saw you saw John Fury yesterday, Tyson Fury's dad, and I don't really know if he's his coach or part of his corner or not, but he went over to one of Team Usyk's guys and he clearly headbutted him and he cracked the guy's cheekbone, and he himself cracked his head open. That is just disgusting. And what if someone would have jumped and beat the crap out of him and, you know, put him in a coma or something? Like, you can't, you're not fighting. Boxing is a sport. You want to talk trash, sell the fight, having, you know, make it entertaining, make it fun. But you get violent like that, you know, he's lucky that Usyk and his team are good people. Very lucky. And I would expect him to be sent on his first flight back home. You can't be acting like that and acting like that's okay. Like, that crosses the line. Because once you provoke, you wake up a bear. But it is what it is. It's boxing. But there's really no room for that in this sport. I love trash talkers. I love, you know, entertaining fighters. But you gotta, you don't pay for free. You're not freestyle. You're fighting. You're a prize fighter. And you don't want to see it escalate to violence or things that are uncalled for. So stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
I'm Ellie Secback. Ellie Secback reporting. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.
FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.